Want to get the most out of your next getaway or business trip? Get over to Belmont, North Carolina, and feel the Hamptonality. At the Hampton and Charlotte Belmont at Montcross, we give you friendly service at a great value. You'll rest easy on our clean and fresh Hampton bed. The crisp white linens and duvet give a fresh start to every guest each morning. Every morning begins with our free hot breakfast, including delicious waffles and hearty oatmeal. And with free Wi-Fi, you're guaranteed to stay connected. We're conveniently located just 8 miles from the center of Charlotte, 7 miles from the Charlotte Douglas International Airport, and just 1 mile from Belmont Abbey College. Book your stay by visiting Hampton.com or by calling 704-825-6100. Again, that's Hampton.com or calling 704-825-6100. Feel the Hamptonality at the preferred hotel for Crusaders athletics, the Hampton in Charlotte Belmont at Montcross.
Pain. Pain doesn't just work 9 to 5. Pain can work round the clock, hours and hours, without even thinking of taking a break. So when you're hurting, you don't want to wait for an appointment. You need relief now. Well, there is a solution. Ortho Carolina's Urgent Care can provide relief for the entire family when time is of the essence. Our after-hours clinics are conveniently located near you when you need us. Ortho Carolina's expert staff is ready to treat strains, sprains, minor dislocations, sports injuries, joint pain, and more. The next time you or a loved one is hurting on an evening or over the weekend, we'll be ready to help. It's the same state-of-the-art care, professionalism, and expertise that's made Ortho Carolina a leader in the Southeast. Pain doesn't happen when it's handy, and you shouldn't have to wait to get relief. Visit OrthoCarolina.com for a list of urgent care locations and hours. Ortho Carolina, you improve.
Just off the 485 loop, minutes from Center City, is a place where the golf is thrilling and the food is a treat for the palate. Pine Island Country Club. Matt Zavanit and his staff have created a golfing and social experience that is unique to the Charlotte Metro. The golf course is one of the best conditioned, aesthetically pleasing courses in the region. The knowledgeable and friendly staff are on the ready to help you play and look your best. The club pool offers a chance to spend the day with family, enjoying the warmth of summer and laughter with friends. If you're in the mood for a night of dinner and conversation, then Pine Island is your spot. Prepare to be treated to an elegant evening at the place you belong, the approachably private Pine Island Country Club. Call Matt Zavanit to schedule your tour by calling 704-394-1422. That's 704-394-1422. Pine Island Country Club. Looking for the latest scores of your favorite Crusaders teams? www.abbeyathletics.com. Feature content such as coaches' interviews. www.abbeyathletics.com. Looking for the brand new Crusaders Corner? You got it, www.abbeyathletics.com. For stats, standing stories, and more, there's only one place in cyberspace when it comes to your Crusaders. That place, www.abbeyathletics.com. Conference Carolinas, competition amongst 10 colleges and universities across North and South Carolina, as well as Tennessee. Over 3,000 student-athletes competing at the highest level of NCAA Division II athletics with annual selections to postseason play. Conference Carolinas is dedicated to student-athletes not only succeeding on the field, but in the classroom and after graduation. Keep up with us at ConferenceCarolinas.com and be sure to follow us at CONF Carolinas on our various social media platforms. Hi folks, Brian Rushing here. Earlier this year, my wife and I went looking for our dream home. You know, the perfect place to have family and friends over, sharing life together, and ultimately, growing old together. You might be in the same boat that we were in. With interest rates at seriously low levels, my question for you is, why haven't you taken the step to home ownership? If you're still looking for the right agent, let me suggest to you Moss Realty. They have an unbelievable inventory at mossrealty.com, and the personal service is second to none. When I called 865-5555, Don Mott made it his personal objective to make sure that we would find our dream home. Folks, Moss Realty turns dream home searching into dream home living. Call them up, 704-865-5555, or go online to mossrealty.com. Moss Realty, turning dream home searching into dream home living. Crusaders Athletics on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network is brought to you by Pine Island Country Club, Domino's, Moss Realty, the Hampton Inn by Hilton at Montcross, and Ortho Carolina, you improve. We take you now to the www.abbeyathletics.com broadcast booth. It's time to raise the red on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network. And good evening. We welcome you to Crusaders Men's Volleyball on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network here inside the Wheeler Center this evening on a Friday night as the Crusaders will be taking on the Coker College Cobras in a non-conference matchup. Brian Rushing here with you this evening. So glad that you could join us tonight. Crusaders 0-2 on the year. They've had two very difficult opponents to start the season as they took on the 10th-ranked nationally George Mason Patriots. They lost in straights on opening night on the 6th of January. Then, just two nights ago, they lose in straight sets to who is the preseason conference favorite in the Barton College Bulldogs. It's not going to get any easier tonight as this Coker College club is a very good club last year. This is a club that had a school record 14 wins. They are a very good club and looking to have a very big year under the tutelage of Eric Snyder. Take a look at Sean Mansey's crew. They're going to try to tweak some things tonight as they've got a brand new starting lineup to work with tonight. And we come back on the other side of this timeout. We'll have those starting lineups as the Crusaders look to raise the red on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network.
Pain. Pain doesn't just work 9 to 5. Pain can work round the clock, hours and hours, without even thinking of taking a break. So when you're hurting, you don't want to wait for an appointment. You need relief now. Well, there is a solution. Ortho Carolina's Urgent Care can provide relief for the entire family when time is of the essence. Our after-hours clinics are conveniently located near you when you need us. Ortho Carolina's expert staff is ready to treat strains, sprains, minor dislocations, sports injuries, joint pain, and more. The next time you or a loved one is hurting on an evening or over the weekend, we'll be ready to help. It's the same state-of-the-art care, professionalism, and expertise that's made Ortho Carolina a leader in the Southeast. Pain doesn't happen when it's handy, and you shouldn't have to wait to get relief. Visit orthocarolina.com for a list of urgent care locations and hours. Ortho Carolina, you improve.
Back here inside the Wheeler Center, pregame show here for the Crusaders as they'll take on the Coker College Cobras this evening. Let's go right into the starting lineup. This evening for Coker College, Devin Whetstone will be the middle blocker this evening, a 6'3 senior out of Missouri City, Texas. Gabriel Castro will be an outside hitter, a 6'3 sophomore out of Belo Horizonte, Brazil. Luca Berger will be a middle blocker, a freshman out of Brazil, a 6'9 freshman this evening. Jackson Gilbert will be an outside hitter, a 6'5 freshman out of Hilliard, Ohio. Sanjay Holloway will also be in the starting lineup, an outside hitter, or I should say, that's João Victor Santos, will be on the right side this evening, a 6'7 sophomore out of Brazil. Alexa Bielic will be the setter this evening, a 6'1 junior out of Serbia. In the libero position this evening, a junior out of Altamonte Springs, Florida, will be Gary Baker, rounding out Eric Snyder's lineup. For the Crusaders, a couple of changes looking very much like it did on opening night. Mansey made the change on Wednesday. He'll go back to that original lineup. Brennan Boehner will be in the middle, a 6'4 senior out of Cleveland, Ohio. Robert Nixon will be an outside hitter, a 6'4 senior out of Chester, Virginia. David Radiszewski will be the libero this evening to start, the senior from Dallas, Texas. Pierce Pleopold, a 6'2 freshman out of Port Orange, Florida, he'll be the setter this evening. Gavin Schaefer will be on the opposite side this evening, the 6'7 junior out of Lititz, Pennsylvania. Aaron Durkees will be a middle hitter, a 6'3 junior out of San Jose, California, the transfer by way of Chico State. And rounding out the lineup will be Liam Maxwell on the outside, a 6'5 freshman out of Manahawkin, New Jersey. So that's tonight's starting lineups, as we're moments away from the start of action here inside the Wheeler Center as the Crusaders take on the Coker College Cobras. When we come back, we'll have the start of the action as we look to raise the red on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network. Want to get the most out of your next getaway or business trip? Get over to Belmont, North Carolina, and feel the Hamptonality. At the Hampton Inn Charlotte Belmont at Montcross, we give you friendly service at a great value. You'll rest easy on our clean and fresh Hampton bed. The crisp white linens and duvet give a fresh start to every guest each morning. Every morning begins with our free hot breakfast, including delicious waffles and hearty oatmeal. And with free Wi-Fi, you're guaranteed to stay connected. We're conveniently located just 8 miles from the center of Charlotte, 7 miles from the Charlotte Douglas International Airport, and just 1 mile from Belmont Abbey College. Book your stay by visiting Hampton.com or by calling 704-825-6100. Again, that's Hampton.com or calling 704-825-6100. Feel the Hamptonality at the preferred hotel for Crusaders athletics, the Hampton in Charlotte Belmont at Montcross.
Pain. Pain doesn't just work 9 to 5. Pain can work round the clock, hours and hours, without even thinking of taking a break. So when you're hurting, you don't want to wait for an appointment. You need relief now. Well, there is a solution. Ortho Carolina's Urgent Care can provide relief for the entire family when time is of the essence. Our after-hours clinics are conveniently located near you when you need us. Ortho Carolina's expert staff is ready to treat strains, sprains, minor dislocations, sports injuries, joint pain, and more. The next time you or a loved one is hurting on an evening or over the weekend, we'll be ready to help. It's the same state-of-the-art care, professionalism, and expertise that's made Ortho Carolina a leader in the Southeast. Pain doesn't happen when it's handy, and you shouldn't have to wait to get relief. Visit OrthoCarolina.com for a list of urgent care locations and hours. Ortho Carolina, you improve.
Just off the 485 loop, minutes from Center City, is a place where the golf is thrilling and the food is a treat for the palate. Pine Island Country Club. Matt Zavanit and his staff have created a golfing and social experience that is unique to the Charlotte Metro. The golf course is one of the best conditioned, aesthetically pleasing courses in the region. The knowledgeable and friendly staff are on the ready to help you play and look your best. The club pool offers a chance to spend the day with family, enjoying the warmth of summer and laughter with friends. If you're in the mood for a night of dinner and conversation, then Pine Island is your spot. Prepare to be treated to an elegant evening at the place you belong, the approachably private Pine Island Country Club. Call Matt Zavanit to schedule your tour by calling 704-394-1422. That's 704-394-1422. Pine Island Country Club. Looking for the latest scores of your favorite Crusaders teams? www.abbeyathletics.com. Feature content such as coaches' interviews. www.abbeyathletics.com. Looking for the brand new Crusaders Corner? You got it. www.abbeyathletics.com. For stats, standing stories, and more, there's only one place in cyberspace when it comes to your Crusaders. That place, www.abbeyathletics.com. Conference Carolinas. Competition amongst 10 colleges and universities across North and South Carolina, as well as Tennessee. Over 3,000 student-athletes competing at the highest level of NCAA Division II athletics, with annual selections to postseason play. Conference Carolinas is dedicated to student-athletes not only succeeding on the field, but in the classroom and after graduation. Keep up with us at ConferenceCarolinas.com and be sure to follow us at CONF Carolinas on our various social media platforms. Hi folks, Brian Rushing here. Earlier this year, my wife and I went looking for our dream home. You know, the perfect place to have family and friends over, sharing life together, and ultimately, growing old together. You might be in the same boat that we were in. With interest rates at seriously low levels, My question for you is, why haven't you taken the step to home ownership? If you're still looking for the right agent, let me suggest to you Moss Realty. They have an unbelievable inventory at mossrealty.com, and the personal service is second to none. When I called 865-5555, Don Mott made it his personal objective to make sure that we would find our dream home. Folks, Moss Realty turns dream home searching into dream home living. Call them up, 704-865-5555, or go online to mossrealty.com. Moss Realty, turning dream home searching into dream home living. Back here on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network as the Crusaders will be taking on the Coker College Cobras. Coker comes in undefeated. They took down St. Andrews in their season opener down in Hartsville, South Carolina. The Crusaders have yet to win a set this season. Quite a different start to the season compared to what they had last year, as they started quickly at 7-0 on the year. Not quite the same success this year, but they have certainly stepped up the early season competition here in 2017. We have the starting lineups. We're ready to go. We've got a good crowd here this evening. It's time to raise the red on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network. Crusaders Athletics on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network is brought to you by Pine Island Country Club, Domino's, Moss Realty, the Hampton Inn by Hilton at Montcross, and Ortho Carolina. You improve. We take you now to the www.abbeyathletics.com broadcast booth. It's time to raise the red on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network. And good evening. We welcome you to the Wheeler Center on the campus of Belmont Abbey College, as the Crusaders of Belmont Abbey will be taking on the Coker College Cobras. Brian Rushing here with you for the call of tonight's action. Nick Reddy running the camera for us this evening, as it should be a fun night of action. Of course, we've got a lot of folks here this evening. It's going to be a raucous crowd here. I'm excited to see what we're going to see out of the crowd this evening. And we're going to be excited also to see what happens with the Crusaders as they're looking to get themselves back to some winning ways. Last year was a program high in wins, a program high in conference wins. Sean Manzi doing a bit of reloading with this club this year, as they've got some guys in the starting lineup that lacked the experience of playing here at Belmont Abbey College, as we had a number of guys graduate last year. So they're going to have to grow up fast, and Sean Manzi's given them the opportunity to be thrown right into the fire. Let's take a look at the starting lineup for the Crusaders. Brennan Boehner will be in the starting lineup, the middle blocker, a 6'4 senior out of Cleveland, Ohio. We'll have Robert Nixon flanked off to his side, a 6'4 outside hitter from Chester, Virginia. Pierce Pleopold will be the setter this evening, a 6'2 freshman out of Port Orange, Florida. Gavin Schaefer will be on the opposite side. 6'7 is his height. He's a junior out of Lititz, Pennsylvania. Aaron Durkees will be a middle hitter. He's a 6'3 junior from San Jose, California, by way of Chico State. Liam Maxwell, one of the players to watch in the conference, a 6'5 freshman outside hitter from Manahawkin, New Jersey. And then playing the libero position this evening, the senior out of Dallas, Texas, David Radiszewski. The Crusaders wearing the red jerseys tonight with the slate gray shorts, facing a Coker College Cobras club that'll be wearing the navy blue jerseys with the gold and white, the gold shorts. Coker in the first set will be going from left to right on your mobile device and your computer screen. The Crusaders will be serving from right to left this evening. So glad that you can join us as we're just about ready for first service, as Coker will start things off. Alexa Bielich will be back to serve for the Cobras. He gets the whistle. The crowd is ready. I hope you're ready for some Friday night volleyball action inside the Wheeler Center. Bielich serves it across. Dug out by Radiszewski. The swing by Maxwell. Can't be dug out. Maxwell puts the Crusaders on the board. 1-0. Pierce Pleopold will be back to serve, the freshman out of Florida. A quick advantage for the Crusaders. Swing taken outside. That's going to go off the deflection. João Victor Santos makes it 1-1. Back to serve for Coker. will be Jackson Gilbert, the 6'5 freshman out of Hilliard, Ohio. He'll toss it high, go toward the service line. That's going to be long. The Crusaders retake the lead at 2-1. Liam Maxwell will serve. Manzi changing the rotation a little bit, as typically he's had in the front of the service rotation. The likes of Robert Nixon. Maxwell tries to go cross court with it, just misses, ties things up at two apiece. Back to serve for Coker will be Devin Whetstone. Whetstone will shuffle forward, hits a knuckler to Radiszewski. That pass is tight. Won't be able to be dug out by Robert Nixon. The kill for Luca Berger makes it 3-2 in favor of the Coker Cobras. Whetstone for his second service. Maxwell to Radiszewski. And there you go. The ambassador, Gavin Schaefer, with the left hand, finds the gap in the center of the floor. Ties things up for the Crusaders at three apiece as Brennan Boehner back to serve. Boehner will basically come right down the center of the floor with the jump service. Zad pass, that's going to be a double contact on Coker. João Victor Santos, not expecting the pass to come his way, was able to mishandle the second contact, and the Crusaders have the 4-3 lead. Boehner will serve it forward, dug out. The swing on the outside is going to go off the block of Gavin Schaefer. The kill for Gabriel Castro, the sophomore out of Belo Horizonte, Brazil, makes it 4-4 as Victor Santos will be back to serve. Santos tosses it forward, serves it deep in, and he miscontacted it. Didn't quite hit it the way he wanted to. The service error gives the Crusaders the 5-4 lead with Gavin Schaefer back to serve. Schaefer serves the swing to the near side. That's a big swing taken there by Luca Berger. Berger ties things up at 5 apiece. The freshman out of Giannia, Brazil, makes it 5-all as Castro goes back to serve for the Cobras. Service goes high, dug out by Maxwell. Pleopold finds Durkees. It gets off the top of the tape, trickles across, and the Crusaders go back up 6-5 with Robert Nixon to serve. Robert Nixon will jump serve it, goes cross court, dug out by Castro. Near side set, it's going to be blocked by Liam Maxwell on the solo, and the Crusaders lead 7-5. Victor Santos took a big swing from the outside, and Liam Maxwell was Johnny on the spot to make the cover at 7-5. Dug out there by the Cobras, the swing goes up the middle, covered by Luca Berger. Pleopold tried to go off the second contact. Now, Valentine, that's going to get pushed to the corner just a little long, out of bounds. 7-6 in favor of the Crusaders. Coker will have the side out as Luca Berger back to serve. A 6'9 freshman out of Brazil. Berger will jump serve it across, dug out by Boehner. Pleopold goes to Maxwell off the block. It'll be point, Crusaders. Eric Snyder contesting. There was a double contact by Pleopold on the set to the near side. Didn't get the call. It's 8-6 in favor of the Crusaders. Aaron Durkees will offer the jump serve. Holds it out front, twist it high, and now jump serves it across the net. The swing taken off the back row. That's going to be dug out by Durkees. They'll have a chance to free it over, does Boehner. Coker with an advantage, and the second ball covered by Alexa Bielich gets the kill. The lead to 8-7 in favor of the Abbey. Bielich back to serve for his second turn in the rotation. Just getting things started inside the Wheeler Center tonight. Radiszewski to Pleopold. Schaefer goes left-handed into the net, ties things up at 8 apiece. Crowd still filing in this evening. There was an outdoor activity with the students prior to the match getting started. They were wandering around all over the grounds here in front of the Wheeler Center entrance. They've now made their way into the gym, ready for some exciting volleyball action. dug out by Castro. The near side pass to Victor Santos goes off the hands of Maxwell. It's 9-8 in favor of the Cobras. Folks, I'll be giving you an email address in just a little bit. You can send me your emails this evening. Let me know that you're tuning in, and certainly if you've got a question, love to hear those as well. Play a pulse. Second ball to Boehner. Boehner was able to catch it at the apex. Gets just enough of it. The kill for the Crusaders evens things at 9 as Pleopold back to serve. Pierce Pleopold back for his second service rotation. Will shuffle forward and send it down the line. That'll be dug out by Coker. The swing by Victor Santos will go off the block of Maxwell. 10-9 in favor of the Cobras. Victor Santos has 12 kills coming into tonight's match, all against St. Andrews on opening night. Back to serve is Jackson Gilbert. Artur Cabral did not start tonight. He has not seen action so far this evening. He had a baker's dozen against St. Andrews. As that serve goes long again, the Crusaders have tied things back up at 10 apiece. Leah Maxwell back to serve. Coker having some difficulties on the service, giving some free points up to the Abbey. Maxwell takes it down the middle. They'll swing back row. Hilliard, I should say Gilbert, will have it off the deflection. The point to Coker. Whetstone back to serve, the senior from Missouri City, Texas, by way of the Village School. That knuckle served to Radishevsky. Backside set to Schaefer. Schaefer took it off the block. Luca Berger tried to kick it high in the air off the deflection. It's tied at 11. Tell you what, you've got to be quite athletic and somewhat nimble with your feet. I would imagine Berger, being from Brazil, probably played a little soccer in his life. It's Berger. Had the opportunity there. He'll find this inside of the line. Giving the lead back to Coker at 12-11. Victor Santos back to serve. One thing's for sure, if the volleyball thing never works out for Berger, I'm sure Coker would love to have him as a power forward on the basketball team. Santos serves it across, dug out by Nixon. That's pretty tight. Pleopold makes the adjustment. They'll play on. That ball's going to get across and down as Gabriel Castro gets the kill for the Cobras, makes it 13-11. Now Sean Manzi is going to have a conversation with the down official on the floor. Sean Manzi saw something there. I'm not quite sure if he was talking about the lift on the first contact from Gary Baker or whether or not he was talking about potentially a throw from Castro. Santos, that pass to Pleopold, and Durkees goes down the middle with the cut angle across his body, gets the kill. Makes it 13-12 in favor of the Cobras. Gavin Schaefer back to serve. Santos goes cross court, misses it wide, no contact. Now we're tied up at 13. With school being back in session, the cheerleaders are here tonight. We're going to have a good crowd throughout the evening. Should be a fun night of volleyball. 14-13 the score. Going back to serve will be Gabriel Castro. Go ahead and send you that email address, folks. BrianRushing@BAC.edu. BrianRushing@BAC.edu. Would love to hear from you this evening. Pleopold, near side set to Durkees. That's going to go off the block of Berger. It's now 15-13 in favor of the Cobras. Berger's size, especially his hands, basically turn into a one-man wall. Pleopold outside. Nixon has that block. Berger once again, 16-13. Luca Berger. So we've got something on the floor that actually came off of a player, perhaps. They pick it up and they toss it away. 3-point lead for the Cobras. Castro jump serve, gets it across, dug out by Boehner. Pleopold again to Nixon. That's going to go off the hands and out of bounds. Crusaders will get the side out, trailing 16-14. Nixon will go back to serve. Robert Nixon with the jump serve goes down the line, dug out by Gilbert. That'll go off the block. Radishevsky with the dig. Maxwell will push it across. Berger will set it over to the side. Gilbert gets the swing, covered by the Crusaders. Maxwell once again, and they'll have to set it. Pleopold back row to Nixon. Nixon takes it to Victor Santos. It'll go off the rafters and come back. The Crusaders with the fortuitous bounce get the point. They trail 16-15. Anytime the ball gets in the rafters here at the Wheeler Center, you don't know what kind of ricochet it'll take. The Crusaders were the advantaged ones there. Side block from Gilbert, or the swing from Gilbert blocked to the floor. The kill for Gilbert makes the score 17-15 in favor of Coker. Luca Berger back to serve. Berger awaits for the signal, gets it, and now he'll proceed. Jump serve, knuckles it over to Maxwell. They'll go back to Maxwell. Maxwell with the adjustment, dug out by Berger. They'll go far side to Gilbert. Gilbert with the kill, and the lead stretches back to three for Coker at 18-15. Crusaders were pretty much point for point with Coker until it got to around the 13-point mark, and then Coker went on a small run. That serve goes into the net. The Crusaders down by two, but really need to get something going. As Aaron Durkees will be back to serve. Rob Valentine goes out. Scavin Schaefer comes back on. Durkees jump serves it. Castro. Pass back row, returns it to Castro, and he tucks it on the paint. Gets the point, 19-16 in favor of Coker. Back to serve. It'll be Stephen Porras, sophomore out of Chesterfield, Virginia, a transfer from Alderson Broaddus, who'll come into the Wheeler Center a little bit later on in the year. Boehner, his swing blocked by Gilbert or Whetstone, take your pick. But the Crusaders find themselves down four. We'll have a timeout on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network here in the first set. Crusaders trail by 4 points. Gaston County is a great place to raise a family. The benefits of the Charlotte Metro blended with the familiarity of several bedroom communities make Gaston a wonderful place to become a first-time homebuyer. But in a shifting market, it's paramount to find a company that will work even harder for you in a very competitive landscape. Might I suggest to you Moss Realty? Moss Realty wants to serve you as an advocate through the home buying process. I've seen the hard work of the staff on a personal level. The attention to detail and their knowledge of Gaston County is top notch. Moss Realty can help you make a pleasure out of life's biggest purchase. Give them a call at 704-865-5555 or log on to mossrealty.com. The number again, 704-865-5555. Moss Realty can turn dream home searching into dream home living. That number one more time, 704-865-5555. That's Moss Realty. Folks, if 2017 is the year you purchase a new home, then you need to call Moss Realty. Moss Realty has the knowledge and personal service to turn homes for sale into homes sold. Call 704-865-5555 or log on to mossrealty.com to talk to an agent today. Service by Porras. He'll toss it up, send it across. Dug out by Radishevsky. Pleopold goes to Boehner, and Boehner gets up high. That'll stop the bleeding momentarily. 2017 the score, but the Crusaders have got to do something from the service line. Checking back in will be Alexa Bielich in place of Porras. Pleopold back to serve. Sends it across to Gilbert. They'll take it back to Gilbert. One-on-one, and Liam Maxwell goes mano-a-mano with Gilbert. He wins that duel, gets the block to the floor. The Crusaders take it to two at 20-18. Baker, the swing now. Boehner has it, and Victor Santos basically took the volley out of the air, went high, was able to finish it off, 21-18 in favor of the Cobras. Gilbert back to serve. An attacking club, this Coker squad, in the first set, almost 600. That'll work. Maxwell goes cross court. He'll get it back. They'll go to the other side to Schaefer. Schaefer takes something off of it. Baker will now go to Victor Santos. That's blocked by Boehner. Second chance. They'll go far side. Castro gets it off the block of Boehner. The lead stretches to four at 22-18. Gilbert tosses it up, sends it across. It's going to be long again. Crusaders getting some help off the service line. A number of service errors for Coker. They've been undaunted as Liam Maxwell back to serve. Coker with the three-point lead. Maxwell with the serve. They'll go to Whetstone. Whetstone finds the line, gets the kill. It's 23-19. Whetstone back to serve. No, he's not. He'll be subbed out for. Checking into the game will be Colton Parsons, the 6'4 junior out of Neenah, Wisconsin. So Parsons looks like he's poised for the jump serve. Tosses it high. Sends it over with the left hand. Radiszewski near side to Schaefer. Schaefer goes off the block of Castro. Gets the kill. The Crusaders trail by three. Brennan Boehner back to serve. And now's the time. The Crusaders cannot give a side out up. If they do, it goes to set point. They'll go far side to Castro. He'll hit the antenna. The point goes to the Crusaders. The set there from Bielich went a little bit too far. Wasn't able to really do a whole lot with it. On the swing was Castro. 23-21 the score. Boehner. Pass tight. Schaefer. And that's going to be a violation. Scavin Schaefer breached the plane. Coker's going to get credit for the point. Manzi doesn't understand what the call was about. So now Robert Nixon going to go over and have a conversation with the chair official. And now Robert Nixon's going to go back for a rebuttal. And now Alexa Bielich comes in to protect the chair umpire by telling Robert Nixon exactly what went down. Victor Santos back to serve, set point for the Cobras. Santos goes high, sends it off the tape to Maxwell. Pleopold goes to Nixon. Nixon gets the kill. As the swing from Nixon was deflected away, Anna Fleetwood, the goalkeeper for the field hockey team, was able to make the stop in the third row. But not before the Crusaders get the point as it goes to 24-22. Austin Quinn will get his first tour of the first set as he'll be back to serve, the freshman from St. Augustine, Florida. That knuckler covered by Gilbert. They'll go to Victor Santos off the block, and we'll have a point to the Crusaders as he stepped inside the 10-foot line on the attack. That's a no-no, and it's 24-23 in favor of Coker. The Crusaders trying to climb back into this one. Slide forward. The serve goes out of bounds, and just like that, the set goes to the way of the Coker College Cobras. The Crusaders trail one set to none. We come back, we'll have second set action on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network. Want to get the most out of your next getaway or business trip? Get over to Belmont, North Carolina, and feel the Hamptonality. At the Hampton Inn Charlotte Belmont at Montcross, we give you friendly service at a great value. You'll rest easy on our clean and fresh Hampton bed. The crisp white linens and duvet give a fresh start to every guest each morning. Every morning begins with our free hot breakfast, including delicious waffles and hearty oatmeal. And with free Wi-Fi, you're guaranteed to stay connected. We're conveniently located just 8 miles from the center of Charlotte, 7 miles from the Charlotte Douglas International Airport, and just 1 mile from Belmont Abbey College. Book your stay by visiting Hampton.com or by calling 704-825-6100. Again, that's Hampton.com or calling 704-825-6100. Feel the Hamptonality at the preferred hotel for Crusaders athletics, the Hampton in Charlotte Belmont at Montcross.
Pain. Pain doesn't just work 9 to 5. Pain can work round the clock, hours and hours, without even thinking of taking a break. So when you're hurting, you don't want to wait for an appointment. You need relief now. Well, there is a solution. Ortho Carolina's Urgent Care can provide relief for the entire family when time is of the essence. Our after-hours clinics are conveniently located near you when you need us. Ortho Carolina's expert staff is ready to treat strains, sprains, minor dislocations, sports injuries, joint pain, and more. The next time you or a loved one is hurting on an evening or over the weekend, we'll be ready to help. It's the same state-of-the-art care, professionalism, and expertise that's made Ortho Carolina a leader in the Southeast. Pain doesn't happen when it's handy, and you shouldn't have to wait to get relief. Visit OrthoCarolina.com for a list of urgent care locations and hours. Ortho Carolina, you improve.
Just off the 485 loop, minutes from Center City. Back here inside the Wheeler Center, the Coker College Cobras take set one by a 25-23 score. The Crusaders tried to climb back into the set, but couldn't quite overcome the deficit that they were dealing with as they were down by as many as 4 points relatively late in this first set. Taking a look at some of the first set numbers, the Crusaders' attacking percentage was not bad. They swung it at a 280 percentage, 12 kills on 25 attacks with just 5 errors. However, you look at Coker, certainly the taller, the bigger team, a 429 attack percentage as they had 3 players with 4 kills, Gabriel Castro, Luca Berger, and Victor Santos, along with Jackson Gilbert's 3. You also take a look at what was going on with the blocks. There were four block assists in the course of the first set for Coker, and certainly that was making things tough on the attack side for the Crusaders. Got a couple emails I want to say hello to. Meredith Kelly checking out the action from West Islip, New York. Meredith, thank you so much for tuning in on a Friday night while you raise the red up in New York State. Thank you so much for tuning in. Want to say hello to Pat Maines checking out the action, likely on his phone or his tablet, something of that nature, from State College, Pennsylvania, home of the Penn State Nittany Lions. Pat, thank you so much for tuning in and raising the red with us this evening. Folks, if you want to send me an email tonight, feel free to do so. Brian Rushing at bac.edu. BRIANRUSHING at bac.edu. Brennan Boehner will start the second set with service. The Crusaders down a set, looking to even things up here in this best of five. Boehner takes something off of it. The swing on the back row to Castro, dug out by Boehner. And Pleopold can't get there. Point 1-0 in favor of Coker. The pass from Boehner went up. Pleopold was not able to get there. The 1-point lead for Coker will send back Alexa Bielich. He'll take something off the serve. Pleopold now to Schaefer. Schaefer, the perfect changeup. Gavin Schaefer went up like he was going to take the full swing and basically just hit a baby loop over the block to even things up at one. Gavin Schaefer slides it with the left hand, covered by Baker. The swing to Victor Santos. He catches the line. There was nobody there blocking. He catches the opposite line, making it 2-1 in favor of Coker as Gilbert goes back to serve. Jump serve for Gilbert, covered by Maxwell. Nixon will have to go stationary, and that was working just enough as he was able to get it around the block, get it to the floor, and it's even at 2. Nixon will be back to serve. Crowd still filing in, probably about 300 here this evening. Not a bad crowd for a Friday night. Nixon will get the help. Baker's going to have to dig it out. Castro will send it over. A free opportunity for the Abbey. Valentine to Maxwell, and that's going to get covered by Victor Santos. As Maxwell had Whetstone and Santos in front of him, he tried to take on Santos. Santos up to the challenge. Whetstone sends it across the way to Boehner. Durkees able to fight through that one. That's going to go out of bounds. The point goes to the Abbey. 3-3 here in the second set. Aaron Durkees will go back to serve. Durkees tosses it high. Got under that one. So he never had a chance to catch the top of the volleyball, spinning it downward. So the service error will give the Coker Cobras the 4-3 lead. Victor Santos back to serve at 4-3 up in the second. Pleopold goes to Boehner. That's deflected off of Luca Berger. Maxwell will take his shot, and he pushed it past Santos. Santos thought he was going to go to the middle. Maxwell saw Santos cheating up the middle. He decided to push it across the body to the corner, sending Pierce Pleopold back to serve at 4-4. That serve well long, 5-4 in favor of the Cobras. Castro back to serve. Castro taps it to Maxwell. Pleopold to Boehner down the middle. Boehner tried to lift it over just a little bit, missed his spot. 6-4 in favor of Coker. Castro floats it to Maxwell. Pleopold to Boehner, and that gets blocked. I believe Gilbert got the better of that one. Berger was also in the neighborhood, but I believe Gilbert's going to get credit for the block at 7-4 in favor of the Cobras. Castro goes cross court with it, dug out by Maxwell. They'll return it to Maxwell, and Maxwell finds the gap, gets it to go, 7-5. Coker with Maxwell back to serve. Liam Maxwell, listed at 6'5", he'll never be confused as the strongest, most imposing volleyball player on the floor. Definitely doesn't carry the look of a Luca Berger, but Liam Maxwell is highly athletic. He gets off the floor quickly and stays up for quite a while, and that's why he's so good on the attack for the Crusaders here in just his freshman season. He'll send it up high across, dug out by Baker. That's going to be a service ace for the Crusaders. Liam Maxwell with that jump serve got pretty good depth on it. Baker was not able to dig it out cleanly. The Crusaders get the service ace, taking it to 7-6. Maxwell tries it again. Baker gets that one more cleanly. Bielich goes to Gilbert. He'll get it off the tape just enough to get the kill for Coker. 8-6 as Luca Berger goes back to serve. Berger tosses it high. That's a firm serve dug out by Maxwell. Schaefer will go cross court. Whetstone with the block. Nixon will free it over to the corner. Bielich near side here to Gilbert. Stayed alive, does Schaefer. Nixon. Could have been a double contact there. No call. It's going to be. And they're going to call the 10-foot violation as the swing on the attack again in front of the 10-foot line. That's a no-no. The Crusaders get the point back, trailing 8-7. Boehner to serve. Crusaders from left to right here in sets 2 and 4 this evening with the red uniforms. That serve goes long, 9-7 in favor of the Cobras. And Bielich back to serve for Coker. Bielich slides forward. Nixon going to get some help from Durkee. Schaefer Didn't really get his feet set. Buries it into the net. 10-7, I should say. In favor of the Cobras. Bielich goes low into the far side. Nixon catches that one into the net. And now it's a four-point advantage for Coker. And I would imagine that if Coker is able to rattle off one more point in this service, it's a strong possibility Manzi's going to try to call a timeout and kind of get this back into position. Zat swing missed by Nixon. It's 12-7. Bielich will be back to serve. A five-point lead for Coker, their largest here of the second set. Maxwell to Leopold. Schaefer takes that off the block, and Gilbert gets it. A six-point lead, 13-7. Manzi wants the timeout now. We'll take it with him. It's the Crusaders trail down a set by six here in the second. We'll be back on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network.
Pain. Pain doesn't just work 9 to 5. Pain can work round the clock, hours and hours, without even thinking of taking a break. So when you're hurting, you don't want to wait for an appointment. You need relief now. Well, there is a solution. Ortho Carolina's Urgent Care can provide relief for the entire family when time is of the essence. Our after-hours clinics are conveniently located near you when you need us. Ortho Carolina's expert staff is ready to treat strains, sprains, minor dislocations, sports injuries, joint pain, and more. The next time you or a loved one is hurting on an evening or over the weekend, we'll be ready to help. It's the same state-of-the-art care, professionalism, and expertise that's made Ortho Carolina a leader in the Southeast. Pain doesn't happen when it's handy, and you shouldn't have to wait to get relief. Visit orthocarolina.com for a list of urgent care locations and hours. Ortho Carolina, you improve.
Folks, don't forget, after tonight's action, we'll have the Ortho Carolina postgame show. We'll take a look at the numbers. We'll tell you what they mean. Then we'll get you ready for your next broadcast on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network immediately following tonight's action. It's the Belmont Abbey Sports Network's Ortho Carolina postgame show. Ortho Carolina, you improved. Six-point lead for Coker here in set number two. Schaefer tries to go one-on-one. It's going to go off the touch of Gilbert. Schaefer gets the kill. It's 13-8 in favor of the Cobras. Gavin Schaefer back to serve. Slides it to Gilbert. It's a tight pass there. Gilbert gets a good swing on it. Boehner can't dig it out. The lead goes back to six. Gilbert to serve. Looks like we've got a stoppage one more time. Maybe some more of whatever it was in the first set that fell off. It's back. That's dug out by Maxwell. Pleopold keeps it alive. Boehner has the swing from the back row go off the hands of Whetstone, out of bounds. Point goes to the Crusaders. So they got a good bounce there, and Robert Nixon's going to try to see if he can do something here on this service to get the Crusaders back into this set. Whetstone with the swing, and that's a big swing. Devin Whetstone, the senior out of Missouri City, Texas, gets the kill. It goes back to a six-point lead. Whetstone out. Parsons in. Coker not attacking in set number two as well, but when you're blocking the way that they are, it really doesn't matter a whole lot. They've really stifled the Crusaders offensively. That's dug out by Parsons. They'll take another chance. Santos keeps it alive. Back row swing for Gilbert. Dug out by Nixon. Pleopold goes to Durkees. That'll be covered by Parsons. They'll bring it across to Victor Santos, and it's covered by Durkees on the floor. He'll get the block. The Crusaders get it to 15-10. Durkees back to serve. Durkees will hold it out in front of him, toss it high, and go get it. End of the net. Lead back to six. Victor Santos will be back to serve. Victor Santos, nine times out of ten, going to be the tallest player on the floor. Except for Luca Berger, who's 6'9", Santos 6'7". Some big kids. Maxwell took a good swing there, got it off the block of Berger. Gets the kill, 16-11 the score. Pleopold back to serve. Floated across to Castro. Bialich to Berger. Berger didn't get all of that one. Now Boehner will go to Maxwell. Maxwell, that's going to be kept alive by Santos. I don't think they're going to get this one across, as that ball just about made its way up into the balcony behind the camera here inside the Wheeler Center. The Crusaders trim it back to four at 16-12. Bialich near side to Castro. Castro finds the gap. Crusaders tried to go one-on-one with Schaefer there. It didn't work. 17-12 the score. Castro back to serve. He'll toss it high and send it across. Dug out by Nixon. Swing from Maxwell. Maxwell. Looked like that one might have gone long, but Castro kept it in play. Gets the kill. We'll never know if it was going to be long. Maxwell gets the point for the Crusaders, back to four. Baker sends it to Bialich. Back row set. Pleopold keeps it alive. Radishevsky continues to play. Maxwell pushes it just a hair long. 18-13 the score. It's Whetstone back in for Parsons. Had Maxwell been able to find the corner there, the crowd would have gotten a little bit of a charge in it. Would have cut this one to three. He just missed. As Luca Berger will check into the contest. Also checking in for Bialich will be Stephen Porras. So Luca Berger back to serve at 18-13. As he puts a mighty swing on it. Boehner went up against Gilbert. Gilbert, the better of it on that one. 19-13 the score. Berger with a second opportunity. That is a flat, hard serve. Nixon goes cross-court, dug out by Berger. That's a tough play there. Gilbert with the swing. He'll get a second one. And Brennan Boehner saw the ball go airborne, knew that Gilbert was going to take the shot. He was there, Johnny on the spot, to get the point. 19-14 the score. As Bryce Sullivan in for Pleopold, as Boehner back to serve. A couple of really good plays there, a couple of really good athletic plays there on both sides. Boehner sends it across and is going to get the service ace. Just like Manzi drew it up, he hits the top of the tape, it trickles over, and the service ace gets the lead back to within four at 19-15. It's a great weapon if you can do it every time. It's just awfully hard. Castro, Whetstone. Took it off the block of Nixon, back up the middle. Lead goes back to five with Porras back to serve. That's a firm serve also. Sullivan's going to have to play it off the net. Durkee's took the swing. And they're going to call a net violation on Coker. And Eric Snyder, to say that he is not enthused by that call would be a bit of an understatement. as he jumped out of his chair immediately to contest that call. Chair official supporting the floor official. Bielich back in. Gavin Schaefer in to serve. Schaefer slides forward to Castro. Near side to Victor Santos. He'll take something off of it to get the kill. The lead stretches back to 5 at 21-16. That serve goes into the net. Crusaders, just like in set number one, really needs to get a run going right now. They have no room for error left in this set. Nixon puts it into the net, back to 5 points. The Crusaders have just not been able to generate anything at a time that they needed it. So Whetstone back to serve. Crusaders out of alignment, making the score 23-17. And now Sean Manzi going to have a conversation briefly with his guys to see where the alignment is. And now he's taking one more shot at it as to who is out of position. And so now the floor official, he's ready for action. The chair up giving some deference to Sean Manzi. Looks like we'll be back to action. Doing a little lip reading. The chair official mentioned something. Maxwell looked over and said, "What does that mean?" So I'm not real sure that Maxwell was understanding what the call was about. Nixon will take the serve. It's back out of bounds. And we go to set point at 24-17. Whetstone to Boehner. Maxwell will push that toward the corner. Kept alive, Victor Santos gets it over to Castro. Boehner will bump it to Maxwell. He'll take the running swing, dug out by Bielich. Now Victor Santos, he'll go cross court with it, hammers it home. And the lead is 25-17 for Coker. They'll be up 2-0. We come back on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network. Want to get the most out of your next getaway or business trip? Get over to Belmont, North Carolina, and feel the Hamptonality. At the Hampton and Charlotte Belmont at Montcross, we give you friendly service at a great value. You'll rest easy on our clean and fresh Hampton bed. The crisp white linens and duvet give a fresh start to every guest each morning. Every morning begins with our free hot breakfast, including delicious waffles and hearty oatmeal. And with free Wi-Fi, you're guaranteed to stay connected. We're conveniently located just 8 miles from the center of Charlotte, 7 miles from the Charlotte Douglas International Airport, and just 1 mile from Belmont Abbey College. Book your stay by visiting Hampton.com or by calling 704-825-6100. Again, that's Hampton.com or calling 704-825-6100. Feel the Hamptonality at the preferred hotel for Crusaders Athletics, the Hampton in Charlotte Belmont at Montcross.
With Domino's Piece of the Pie Rewards, you earn a free medium two-topping pizza after just 6 online orders of $10 or more. Need some reasons to order? Throw a half birthday party for your husband.
Happy 36 and a half.
Or your cat. Or get in touch with your vegetarian side.
Hold the pepperoni.
But we think free pizza's reason enough. Start earning points toward free pizza with our $5.99 mix and match deal at Domino's.com today. Rewards program is open only to U.S. residents 13 and older with a pizza profile account. Only one order per day earns points. Complete details at Domino's.com/rewards. You must select this limited time offer. Prices, participation, and charges may vary.
Back here inside the Wheeler Center, the Crusaders have their work cut out for them. They're down 2-0. We'll see what they can do here in set number 3. Folks, wanted to let you know it's a big day here at Belmont Abbey College on February the 11th as we welcome back our Belmont Abbey graduates of the last decade. That's Abbey Gold. This alumni event will be held at 4 o'clock inside the Lowry Alumni Building. Now around that is going to be the season opener for women's lacrosse, as women's lacrosse will get going at 12 o'clock in the afternoon. They'll take on the Barton College Bulldogs. Baseball will be in action against Tusculum that afternoon in a doubleheader. The 4 o'clock cookout is where the Abbey Gold alums can get together for food, fun, and fellowship right before the Conference Carolinas doubleheader inside the Wheeler Center between the Crusaders as they take on the Crusaders, the North Greenville University Crusaders. If you need more information, contact Chris Goff-Peeler at 704-461-6663. We can't wait to see all of our graduates of the last decade back here inside the Wheeler Center on February the 11th as it's Abbey Gold Weekend here at Belmont Abbey College. So we'll go to the third set. The Crusaders have lost sets by scores of 25-23 and 25-17. They really weren't in the second set after the initial few points were scored, as they were at an attack percentage of a negative 36. That's certainly not going to get it done by any stretch of the imagination. You take a look at Coker. They came back to earth with their attack percentage, but they were still at 278 for the match. They're at 370. That's going to win most matches. Crusaders sitting at 113, and their inability to generate offense this evening has been a real bugaboo for them. They've had opportunities, as there have been many service errors for Coker. They have six so far through two sets. If my numbers are correct, they had five service errors in the first set, so they took more of a conservative approach in the second set with their service game, and it really didn't seem to affect them a whole lot, as Bielich will be back to serve here in set three for Coker. Good crowd here this evening. Kids on a Friday night waiting to get the weekend started, starting it here inside the Wheeler Center. Radishevsky, the swing taken, as it'll go out of bounds. It'll be on the line, the point to Coker. Austin Quinn took the swing, the ball deflected off of Coker, and it landed right on the sideline. That's a real heartbreaker there. Victor Santos takes the tight pass. Sullivan not able to track it down. 2-0 in favor of the Cobras. Crusaders played Wednesday night against Barton. Lost in straight sets. Ran out of gas in the third set. Maxwell blocked by Whetstone. It's 3-0. And the Crusaders maybe not fighting fatigue tonight, just simply don't have it. Bielich sends it over. Victor Santos trying to sell the idea that the serve went over, of course, playing games with the floor official. Sullivan gets it over to Baker. Whetstone takes something off of it, and that's heading our way. Liam Maxwell, he slid before getting to the table. Otherwise, he might have been in Brooks Ledger's lap. 4-1 lead for Coker. Gilbert back to serve. Pass is tight. Sullivan keeps it alive. And Austin Quinn gets the kill off the swing. It was all that Sullivan could do. Bryce Sullivan, it's all that he could do to just get the ball off the net. He was able to one-hand the ball over to Quinn, and Quinn got the kill. Maxwell goes cross-court. Whetstone finds the space. 5-2 in favor of the Cobras. That pass tight. Castro will get an opportunity. They'll go backside off the 10-foot line. Sullivan still working to get there. Radishevsky will free it over. Bielich backside to Victor Santos. He gets the kill. And it looks like Eric Snyder's Cobras are trying to strangle the life out of the Crusaders here in the early portions of this third set. As that serve will float deep. Takes the lead back down to three at 6-3. Austin Quinn to serve. Quinn, the freshman out of St. Augustine, Florida. Shuffles it forward. Bielich to Castro. And it's going to be a net violation on the Crusaders. So João Victor Santos back to serve with his club up by four. No action here at home for the Crusaders tomorrow. Schaefer will cut that over the net. Bielich will take the second ball. And it's 8-3 in favor of the Coker Cobras. Basketball makes the long trip to Wilson, North Carolina, some 3.5 hours away from home for a 2 and 4 o'clock doubleheader. Barton College will be bringing that broadcast to you as that serve goes long. It's a pivotal matchup for both the men and the women. I would argue that the men probably need the game as much as the women do, as it would be a bit of a statement win. Luca Berger gets the kill off the swing, 9-4 the score. Castro back to serve. He'll toss it up, send it over. Dug out by Radishevsky. Quickly to Durkees, has that dug out by Castro. They'll attack with Gilbert, and Gilbert puts it into the net. So the Crusaders here have an opportunity, if they can just heat up a little bit, to get back into the set. Folks, as we get closer to February, check out all the news and information on the home of the Crusaders, www.abbeyathletics.com. With the start of the spring sports and the wrapping up of the regular season for basketball, it's the perfect time of year to follow the Crusaders on www.abbeyathletics.com. Boehner, something off that serve. Crusaders trying to win the joust. Durkees and Bielich go up even, and the swing by Victor Santos is somehow able to get over the net. The lead at 10-5. Berger back to serve. Berger sends it firmly across. Maxwell will send it over to Schaefer. Schaefer pushes it wide, out of bounds. 11-5. The lead up to a half a dozen for Coker. And Berger back to serve. Sends that one firmly across. Sullivan with the set to Maxwell. Berger basically takes it over. I don't know if Santos can do anything with it. He tried as it hit the side post. That one would have gone on SportsCenter if it gets over. It does not. The Crusaders get the point, taking it to 11-6. Durkee's back to serve. Floats it across. Dug out by Boehner. Sullivan gets it across. And now Bielich is going to take it. It's going to be a point on the Crusaders as Bielich lifted it over. So Bielich trying to argue his point, but the call was initially made by the chair official. So it's 11-7 in favor of Coker. So apparently the explanation is satisfactory to Bielich. We'll play on. Durkees will slide forward, hit the knuckler. Victor Santos and Liam Maxwell gets the block. Victor Santos was impressed. He gave him the thumbs up. acknowledging Maxwell, going up and making a very solid block as that one was deflected straight down, no more than 3 feet off the center line. Durkees back to Castro. Whetstone. Whetstone does a pretty good job of finding the seams. Gets the kill, the lead to 12-8. Bielich back to serve. Slides forward, sends it over to Maxwell. Sullivan, that ball's still alive. Somebody's going to have to free it over. Boehner will do that. Bielich back to Whetstone. He'll try to keep it alive, can't do so. The point to Coker. Sullivan quickly back to Maxwell, and Victor Santos returns the favor. Where Victor Santos took the swing, had it blocked by Maxwell. Maxwell treated quite unfairly there by Santos as he draws even with that block. Boehner takes something off of it, gets it past Baker, the point to the Crusaders, making it 14-9. Bryce Sullivan back to serve. Crusaders will be back inside the Wheeler Center on Tuesday. They'll re-enter conference play against Mount Olive. Bielich to Victor Santos, took something off of it. Backline set to Boehner, kept alive. They'll still have a chance to take a swing. And Victor Santos, on what normally would have been a free ball, goes up and gets it and drops it in the corner. And that'll send Jackson Gilbert back to serve at 15-9. Radishevsky, Sullivan, Boehner pushes, gets it to Bielich. Baker, back row set. Gilbert didn't get it cleanly. The Crusaders draw back to within five. Maxwell to serve. Folks, don't forget, you want to send me an email this evening. We'd love to hear from you. Brian Rushing at BAC.edu. Redstone couldn't get the pass high enough. Sends it into the net. The point to the Crusaders, trims it to four at 15-11. Give you that email address one more time. It's the ball sent into the net. BRIANRUSHING at BAC.edu. Colton Parsons will be in to serve for Coker at 16-11. Parsons tosses high, sends the lefty over. Passes tight, and Berger hit the net on the follow-through. Berger, the freshman, was so amped up by seeing that ball. His follow-through carries him into the net. Zat point gift wrap by Luca Berger to the Crusaders. Santos. Didn't get it cleanly. As the play still alive, and the Crusaders can't get it across the net. Victor Santos looked like he got caught up in midair as to whether he was going to dink it over or take the full swing. So he kind of did a hybrid. Took a swing, but didn't really hit it cleanly. Looks like he might have got it with the index finger, and that was it. Santos back to serve at 17-12. Change up on the service. Sullivan goes to Durkees, and they can't complete the play. And Sean Manzi will take a timeout. We'll take the timeout with Manzi. It's the Crusaders trail in set number three. At 18-12, we'll be back on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network. Looking for up-to-the-minute scores of your favorite Crusader sports? www.abbeyathletics.com. Feature content, including coaches' interviews. www.abbeyathletics.com. Crusaders broadcast on demand. That's right, www.abbeyathletics.com. Your online source for all things Crusaders can be found in one place. www.abbeyathletics.com. Back here inside the Wheeler Center, the Crusaders. The campus getting ready to get cranked up with a lot of athletic events. February is going to be quite a month. You've got men's and women's lacrosse getting started, baseball, softball getting started. 10 spring sports. Men's and women's golf, men's and women's lacrosse, track and field. It's going to be a full spring, and we'll be bringing so much of it to you on www.abbeyathletics.com. Stats, standings, stories, and of course, the Belmont Abbey Sports Network. Coker, 37 kills, 14 attack errors, and 69 total attacks, have a .333 attack percentage. Victor Santos back to serve. His club in front, 18-12. Sullivan goes to Boehner. Gilbert looked like it was going to go to his left. Boehner changed him up. Went to his right, gets the kill, and Gaffin Schaefer back to serve. Victor Santos takes the swing, dug out by Radiszewski, and it hits the rafters and comes down harmlessly. 19-13. You do your best to try to figure out where the ball is going to hit the rafters and come down. Just never seems to get there. Castro puts a lot of topspin and cross swings it out of bounds. Point to the Crusaders. Boehner back to serve. Bielich goes far side to Gilbert, dug out by Schaefer. Sullivan quickly works with Boehner. They'll change it up to Baker. The swing from the back row. Castro takes it off the block. 20-14 the score. Substitution. Checking on for Coker. Steven Porras. Devin Whetstone also into the match for Parsons. Luca Berger back to serve. Tosses it high, sends it across. Near side swing to Maxwell, goes down the line, gets the kill. And that'll send Aaron Durkees back to serve. But not before a substitution comes on for the Crusaders. It's Colton Kelly, the 6'1 freshman out of West Islip, New York, will get his first tour of duty. He'll shuffle forward, sends the serve over, and it's going to miss the back line by just a hair. 21-15 the score. Porras to serve for Coker. Dug out by Maxwell. The pass tight. Whetstone finds the corner. The lead out to 7. Coker going to try to put a bow on this one as Robert Nixon comes back on in place of Liam Maxwell. So Coker looks like they're going to take their season record to 2-0. As they've yet to give up a set, and the Crusaders, unless something miraculous here, not going to come away with a set as there's a net file, or I should say, Boehner attacks inside the 10-foot line off the back row, making it 23-15. So the Crusaders could just never get into sync this evening. Certainly looked like they lost steam in the third. Sad serve. It's going to go low. 23-16 the score. Sullivan back to serve. Bielich in for Porras. Bialich goes to Santos, who sends it over with the right foot. Santos keeps trying it. The swing from Austin Quinn blocked by Devin Whetstone. And that takes us to match point at 24-16. Serve dug out by Boehner. Sullivan to Schaefer. Schaefer, it'll go outside the antenna, and that'll do it. The Crusaders fall in straight sets by a 25-16 score. When we come back, we'll have the final numbers as the Crusaders fall this evening in straight sets to Coker. We'll be back on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network. Want to get the most out of your next getaway or business trip? Get over to Belmont, North Carolina, and feel the Hamptonality. At the Hampton and Charlotte Belmont at Montcross, we give you friendly service at a great value. You'll rest easy on our clean and fresh Hampton bed. The crisp white linens and duvet give a fresh start to every guest each morning. Every morning begins with our free hot breakfast, including delicious waffles and hearty oatmeal. And with free Wi-Fi, you're guaranteed to stay connected. We're conveniently located just 8 miles from the center of Charlotte, 7 miles from the Charlotte Douglas International Airport, and just 1 mile from Belmont Abbey College. Book your stay by visiting Hampton.com or by calling 704-825-6100. Again, that's Hampton.com or calling 704-825-6100. Feel the Hamptonality at the preferred hotel for Crusaders athletics, the Hampton in Charlotte Belmont at Montcross.
Pain. Pain doesn't just work 9 to 5. Pain can work round the clock, hours and hours, without even thinking of taking a break. So when you're hurting, you don't want to wait for an appointment. You need relief now. Well, there is a solution. Ortho Carolina's Urgent Care can provide relief for the entire family when time is of the essence. Our after-hours clinics are conveniently located near you when you need us. Ortho Carolina's expert staff is ready to treat strains, sprains, minor dislocations, sports injuries, joint pain, and more. The next time you or a loved one is hurting on an evening or over the weekend, we'll be ready to help. It's the same state-of-the-art care, professionalism, and expertise that's made Ortho Carolina a leader in the Southeast. Pain doesn't happen when it's handy, and you shouldn't have to wait to get relief. Visit OrthoCarolina.com for a list of urgent care locations and hours. Ortho Carolina, you improve.
Just off the 485 loop, minutes from Center City, is a place where the golf is thrilling and the food is a treat for the palate. Pine Island Country Club. Matt Zavannett and his staff have created a golfing and social experience that is unique to the Charlotte Metro. The golf course is one of the best conditioned, aesthetically pleasing courses in the region. The knowledgeable and friendly staff are on the ready to help you play and look your best. The club pool offers a chance to spend the day with family, enjoying the warmth of summer and laughter with friends. If you're in the mood for a night of dinner and conversation, then Pine Island is your spot. Prepare to be treated to an elegant evening at the place you belong, the approachably private Pine Island Country Club. Call Matt Zavannett to schedule your tour by calling 704-394-1422. That's 704-394-1422. Pine Island Country Club. Looking for the latest scores of your favorite Crusaders teams? www.abbeyathletics.com. Feature content such as coaches' interviews. www.abbeyathletics.com. Looking for the brand new Crusaders corner? You got it. www.abbeyathletics.com. For stats, standing stories, and more, there's only one place in cyberspace when it comes to your Crusaders. That place, www.abbeyathletics.com. Conference Carolinas, competition amongst 10 colleges and universities across North and South Carolina, as well as Tennessee. Over 3,000 student-athletes competing at the highest level of NCAA Division II athletics with annual selections to postseason play. Conference Carolinas is dedicated to student-athletes not only succeeding on the field, but in the classroom and after graduation. Keep up with us at ConferenceCarolinas.com and be sure to follow us at CONF Carolinas on our various social media platforms. Hi folks, Brian Rushing here. Earlier this year, my wife and I went looking for our dream home. You know, the perfect place to have family and friends over, sharing life together, and ultimately, growing old together. You might be in the same boat that we were in. With interest rates at seriously low levels, my question for you is, why haven't you taken the step to home ownership? If you're still looking for the right agent, let me suggest to you Moss Realty. They have an unbelievable inventory at mossrealty.com, and the personal service is second to none. When I called 865-5555, Don Mott made it his personal objective to make sure that we would find our dream home. Folks, Moss Realty turns dream home searching into dream home living. Call them up, 704-865-5555, or go online to mossrealty.com. Moss Realty, turning dream home searching into dream home living. Back here on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network, the Ortho Carolina postgame show. So we're back here on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network. The Crusaders fall in straight sets this evening by a 3-0 score. To be quite honest with you, Coker came in here and took care of business. The Crusaders could not get anything going, and by the time the third set rolled around, they had just simply run out of steam. And there was nothing that they could do about it this evening against a very good Coker club. Be interested to see how Coker does for the rest of their year. Looking at what we've seen, three difficult opponents for the Crusaders to get the year started. Hopefully the Crusaders can begin to build some momentum, get in sync offensively, and see if they can get to start piling up some wins like they were able to last year. You take a look at some of the numbers, a 351 attack percentage for Coker, as they had just one player in double figures and kills. And the fact of the matter is they were able to choose any number of people that they wanted to attack this evening. Victor Santos led the way. He had 12 kills and 21 attacks, a 333 attack percentage, a very solid number. Devin Whetstone, he had 8 kills, had on a 9 attacks. He had an attack percentage of 778 on the evening, which was very solid. Alexa Bielich had 25 assists on the evening. You take a look at Diggs. The leader in Diggs was Gabriel Castro. He had a segment of services from the Crusaders that he basically picked off every one of them and helped set the offense for Coker. As they hit 351 from an attack standpoint, they had just one service ace, but that really didn't matter. They didn't need to lean heavily on the service aces, as once they were able to quell away their service errors in the second and third set, they were able to cruise in the three-set win this evening. For the Crusaders, the leader in kills was Liam Maxwell. He's put together a couple of pretty steady performances so far. Hasn't had a chance to take as many swings as maybe he would like, I'm sure, as the matches have all been three sets so far this season. But he has 6 kills to lead the Crusaders this evening. Pierce Pleopold had 17 assists on the night. The leader in digs for the Crusaders was Brennan Boehner, as he had 4 on the evening. The Crusaders unable to really generate any offense whatsoever. They were 280 in the first set, and then things did not improve. In set number 2, they were 036 negatively. In the third set, they were at a negative 136. So things did not go well in the second and third sets, both offensively or defensively, as Coker gets the three-set win this evening. We come back on this Ortho Carolina timeout. We're going to go ahead and get back to possibly an interview with Sean Manzi if we're able to spot him. If not, we'll put a bow on it this evening as the Crusaders fall in straight sets to Coker. This is the Belmont Abbey Sports Network.
Hey. pain. Pain doesn't just work 9 to 5. Pain can work round the clock, hours and hours, without even thinking of taking a break. So when you're hurting, you don't want to wait for an appointment. You need relief now. Well, there is a solution. Ortho Carolina's Urgent Care can provide relief for the entire family when time is of the essence. Our after-hours clinics are conveniently located near you when you need us. Ortho Carolina's expert staff is ready to treat strains, sprains, minor dislocations, sports injuries, joint pain, and more. The next time you or a loved one is hurting on an evening or over the weekend, we'll be ready to help. It's the same state-of-the-art care, professionalism, and expertise that's made Ortho Carolina a leader in the Southeast. Pain doesn't happen when it's handy, and you shouldn't have to wait to get relief. Visit orthocarolina.com for a list of urgent care locations and hours. Ortho Carolina, you improve.
Looking for up-to-the-minute scores of your favorite Crusader sports? www.abbeyathletics.com. Feature content, including coaches' interviews, www.abbeyathletics.com. Crusaders broadcast on demand. That's right, www.abbeyathletics.com. Your online source for all things Crusaders can be found in one place, www.abbeyathletics.com. Back here inside the Wheeler Center for the final segment of the Ortho Carolina postgame show as the Crusaders fall straight sets this evening to Coker. As you see, women's volleyball actually looks like they're going to get some workout time in. They may have a clinic going on, not exactly sure. Whatever the case may be, they're filling up the arena this evening for a little late evening activity as the Crusaders men fall this evening by straight sets. Let's give you an idea of what's going to be happening next week on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network. It starts quietly early in the week as men's volleyball will be on the air at 6:45 on Tuesday night as Mount Olive comes into town. It'll be a 7 o'clock start, 6:45 airtime. So the Crusaders will take on the Mount Olive Trojans. From there, we'll have matches for basketball Friday night. Lees McRae comes in to take on the Belmont Abbey Crusaders. That's a doubleheader, 5:30 for the women, 7:30 for the men. And then an afternoon doubleheader here inside the Wheeler Center on Saturday as the Crusaders will be taking on King University. That's a 2 and 4 o'clock start. Another event that we've got going on that's going to be quite interesting is Friday morning and afternoon we'll have the Midwest Regional Duels. It's Belmont Abbey College, Limestone College, the University of North Carolina, Pembroke, Tiffin, and Findlay all get inside the Wheeler Center starting at 8 a.m. on Friday morning, and they'll take part in the Midwest Regional Duels, part of a two-day competition that will also see those teams go down to Newberry College on Saturday to wrap up the weekend of action. So it should be a full slate of action here inside the Wheeler Center as we get closer and closer to next weekend. Of course, the Crusaders basketball teams will be on the road tomorrow taking on Barton in what should be two very competitive contests in Conference Carolina's play. So for tonight, the men's team falls to 0-3 on the season with a straight set loss to the Coker Cobras. And they'll look to try to get their first win of the season against Mount Olive on Tuesday night. Until then, folks, we hope that you have a fantastic weekend. We can't wait to see you next time on the Ortho Carolina postgame show. This has been the Belmont Abbey Sports Network. Good night, everybody. Crusaders Athletics on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network has been brought to you by Pine Island Country Club, Domino's, Moss Realty, the Hampton Inn by Hilton at Montcross, and Ortho Carolina, you improve. Don't forget, your online home for all things Crusaders can be found at www.abbeyathletics.com. We thank you for tuning in. We can't wait to see you next time right here on the Belmont Abbey Sports Network. On the Belmont Abbey Sports Network has been brought to you by